Do you find yourself constantly dropping things, dropping your keys, picking them up, dropping a book, picking it up, dropping something light, picking it up? I knew someone with RSI who actually had to get one of those web coverings for the bottom of her sink because she was constantly dropping glasses and breaking them. So this is a very common manifestation. It's a symptom of RSI and one of the things that can happen when you have it. So I thought to explain this phenomenon, we bring in our expert, our chief medical expert, Dr. Robert Markison. He's a hand surgeon in San Francisco. Welcome back to the show, Dr. Markison. So what can you tell
us? Glad to be with you.
Glad to have you. So what about dropping things all the time? Why does that happen?
Well, first of all, you want to make sure that there is not some central neurological problem that does require an expert opinion from a neurologist to kind of check and see what it is. If it's a mechanical problem, then we're talking about us versus geckos. Geckos are so wonderful, and they have this wonderful combination of sweat and other secretions and the complex topography of their equivalent of fingerprints. They can climb on glass, climb on the ceilings. They are just marvelous. It's important to know who we are and who we are not, comparative anatomy. Now, sweat fibers parallel sensory fibers and peripheral nerves. So that means the combination of sweat and the topography of a fingerprint is very determining of your ability to hold on to an object. So if you start to get, for example, carpal tunnel, compression of the nerve that goes out thumb, index, middle, and ring, and it becomes advanced, then you won't have adequate sensory feedback to regulate the power of pinch and grip. So you'll lose the ability to say, oh gosh, I'm not holding that very well, meaning a little carpal tunnel compression of sensory feedback. And in a later case, you can have loss of sweat. So what are you doing? You're checking for sweat. How do you do that? Well, you could go on the cell phone surface and see if there's a little drag between the fingertip and the glass of the cell phone, meaning you've got proper sweat. Then you go over the median nerve territory, the index, middle, thumb, index, middle, and maybe some of the ring, and see if you're dragging equally. What I described in the literature some time ago is what I call the pen drag test. I've got a little pen here, so I drag it across. Oh, gee, it's like gliding on silk. Not enough sweat. Could it be carpal tunnel? Could it be carpal tunnel? Could it be carpal tunnel? And then I get back to the ulnar, which is seldom compressed. Oh, gee, it's dragging right there. The good old pen drag test. That's simple enough. So on a relatively sweat-free surface that's denervated by virtue of carpal tunnel or other compression, then you're going to drop stuff. Not only will you not be regulating power, knowing where parts are, proprioception, but you won't have enough combined sweat with topography of fingertip to really hold on. And that's, again, time to check with somebody who knows what he or she is doing.
So as I'm understanding you, a little bit of sweat is a good thing.
Yes. I mean, some people are hyperhidrotic. They're sweating all the time.
Which is not.
I mean, that may not be the same thing as sympathetic overactivity up in the neck thorax region. But hyperhidrosis is relatively rare, cold, clammy, sweaty hands. But again, on the RSI side, if there's a little nerve compression, then you can start to go dry and have inadequate combination sweat and fingerprint and gripping.
That is so fascinating. I read somewhere that as one gets older, you lose the ridges in your fingerprints. And I never knew before I started studying the hand that the fingerprints were actually helping you, as just as you said, to grip and grasp things, to keep your grip.
Yeah, it's a wonderful design, but again, far short of a gecko.
Well, we have things that geckos don't, so I guess we're good, but it's so fascinating. Thank you so much for this explanation of why we drop things. And it sounds like there's hope that people who are constantly dropping things, once they start resolving a little bit of their repetitive strain injury issues, they'll get their grip back.
That's it. Good.
Thanks, Dr. Markison.